It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer of Payne Capital Management. And the global markets finished little change this week as prices continue to adjust to rising interest rates and an uptick in inflation expectations on the part of investors. One of the key reasons not to be overly concerned is that the earnings-driven stage of the secular bull market still appears to be alive and well. You know, lost among these headlines about the return of volatility and inflation is that the fourth quarter earnings season's been extremely strong. And this is before the real impacts of the tax bill take effect, considering that bill wasn't even passed until late fourth quarter. Furthermore, our current 2018 bottom-up consensus operating earnings estimate for the S&P 500 is up to $156 per share. Now, 2 months ago, we stood at $145 per share. That's a 7.6% increase in earnings expectations. Well, what's that mean to you as an investor? It means the P.E. ratio, the price-to-earnings ratio for the S&P 500, has actually fallen to 17.4, which is just above historically normal. So stocks aren't a concern. What you should be concerned about are your bonds, especially if you own bond funds. Our definition of fixed income is very simple. Bonds with permanence and definition, which is a bond with a fixed rate of return and a stated date of redemption. In other words, your downside risk is limited to the return of all your money with interest. Better yet, as rates rise, you can reinvest your maturing bonds at a higher interest rate. So stay invested, buy the dips in your stock portfolio, and reduce the risk in your portfolio by owning a portfolio of high quality fixed income bonds that come due.